number one. It was the first.
Yeah.
Our pilot, so-called. You know, that two-parter, I did a little like it. And I love it. I really enjoyed Frank Dorff and his rhythm. And of course, to get the chance to set the tone in a comedic way for the show.
Yeah.
You know, going into the discotheque and saying, I shouldn't wish to be this big. Things like that. And I think we hit pretty much hit the mark. And people loved it. And I enjoyed it because I'm the one mostly that fought for the comedy. The tongue-in-cheek, satirical elements.
Were you familiar with Batman in the animated form, the animated 90s animated series, and the work of like Kevin Conroy?
Not them, because I, thank you, I preceded them. Well, you mean afterward?
Yeah.
Yes, to an extent. I was so pissed off that they didn't ask me to do it.
And you should be.
I became somewhat familiar. As a matter of fact, people ask me about the animated comics and stuff. Well, I find this not really a comic. That's when I was visiting. I was about 12.
Yeah.
But you see, it was a different time and different comics. Now there are the graphic novels and the art books. And I go through and wish to see what's happening. And I do see, you know, pieces of the new world. The dark ones, just to see what's happening. And then I realize,
Mr. West,
that's it.
Well, actually, on Batman the Animated Series, you were the Grey Ghost.
You know, Warner's system about maybe made a duet of the Grey Ghost animated series.
That'd be cool.
Well, that's what people say. And I love the character.
For me.
Mr. West, what made you come back to do the Return of the King Crusader?
With this? The paycheck. And, you know, the challenge of really doing it again. Trying to have fun. You know, today's the new days. You know, back then was very... full of vengeance, deep-seated angst, and so on. And they're very dark. My Batman was just fun.
That's true.
And, you know, I try to make it funny and fun. I'm not happy Batman.
What was it like getting back together with Burt Ward and Julie Newmar?
Well, it was interesting in that... as I expected, they immediately got back into the atmosphere with me. And I thought, you know, that's because, like, if Bert and I will do a Comic Con, you know, it's immediate. I mean, he may hate me. I may hate him. But as soon as we're together performing, you say, it's back. Yeah. It's not that we hate each other, but I'm saying. You know, we're different ages, different lifestyles, and attitudes, but it's there. It's there.
Very nice. Very nice. Very nice.
Am I boring you again?
No, you're not.
No.
Not
at all.
Do you have any advice for future Batman?
Would you love to finish? Of course.
Yeah, absolutely.
He said it's the only time it's ever happened.
Go ahead. Do you have advice for future Batman?
Advice?
Yeah.
Nonviolence. And let the costume work for you. And put a little humor in it. You know, because I think it's about time to really. such memories. You can't take it anymore. I'm going home and I'm going to suck my thumb.
What was it like to recite, like, the dialogue you did in '66, like, you know, crossing the street and, you know, things like that, that Batman would correct Robin all the time?
I love it. Because it was a great one. Nobody would tell
me.
Yeah, yeah. The way he was. And I thought it really funny. And so did he. And so did the audience. So that's, it gave me a chance to play a more straight ahead Batman from moment to moment. And to give the kids little homilies, little technical lessons, whatever. But they really picked up. And most of them didn't become murderers.
So over the years, you've been to a lot of conventions and stuff like that. You've seen a lot of the fans. What have they asked you to repeat from the original series the most?
To repeat?
What lines from the original series?
As part of a scene or something.
Yeah.
You know, it's funny. When I walk on a stage with one of these things, they say, oh, do the Batusi. Lord. And, well, they'll want to know how we did the walk lines. And I have to spill it and say, well, we put the building on its side. And then we attach fishing filament line to the capes for gravity. And somebody said, well, we can see that. And I said, that's okay. Let the audience see. It's funny. And the audience kind of knows. They think, maybe. So, did that work? Yeah.
You work with a lot of guest stars, and that was one of the big selling points of the show. Who do you regret not having had a chance to work with on this show? Who are some of the people you wish you got a chance to be on Batman with?
That's a question I've never had.
Well, thank you.
One day, Kim Novak called my assistant and said, do you think he would have a chance? Should I spill?
Yes,
very much. And so I put on my bathrobe over my costume, took off the gown, up close this Jaguar convertible with her driver, and I said, oh my God, I'm a lot worse than that. I got in the car, and we had lunch, and we had a good time. And she took me back to the school, and I just had a feeling that she really wanted to do the show with me. It's all but she wanted to do the show. And she'd just come off, I think, that wonderful movie with Jimmy Stewart.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
Vertigo?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And so I was quite impressed, and I would have loved to have been looking for her. I think Henry Fowler. Yeah. Maybe Kirk Douglas. And if he'd been alive, Robert Donat. But the guy, it was my understanding, he was terrible. And he died, you know, very young. He was really good. But who else? Maybe Louis B. Mayer. Yes. You know, to kind of show him what it's like out there. Yeah, I know a lot of people are so good. But we have lost. You know, Cesar Romero. was Peggy, baby. And Frank Gorshin was really Caesar with the energy. I really was lucky to work with these people. And I learned, you know, you look face to face or cow to face with them. And it was wonderful the way, because they listened and they weren't selfish performers. So the unit was great to have them back. You look for that in the city.
We just heard that.
Excuse me.
We just heard that Ben Affleck's Batman was maybe called the Batman. How do you feel about that?
Well, I'm not too sensitive. Yes, I think it's smart because it's simple. And it certainly puts the focus on him as the Batman. But he knows, as you and everyone, that I'm the classic. So I think it's smart for him to call the Batman.
Mr. West.
Okay, then I'm going to drop the D next time. Just play Batman.
Mr. West, I just wanted to ask you a question here. If the planets were realigned again that allowed you to make a second installment, would you go for it?
He knows something.
Yeah.
He knows something. I have a gag order.
Oh, one of those things.
But tonight, let me clue you. If you're there tonight, or this afternoon, like whenever they show the movie, you will learn something about what you're
watching. Thank you, thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Now, Bert Ward actually said that the movie is going to shock viewers. He says it's and to use your term, blow your mind. He said the same thing, that the movie will blow your mind. What about this movie? What should fans expect?
They can expect the usual excellence to which they become so accustomed. They badly.
I have to actually commend you on some of your work on The Outer Limits. I thought Phillips on there, you were awesome. And also a little movie that is also one of my personal hidden classics, Robinson Crusoe and
Me.
So it's really nice working.
The Monkey and Me and Paul Mantee.
That's right.
Any questions?
I just have like one little request. If you could say hi to my friend, he's a big fan of yours since he was a kid.
The nerve! Where's your father? Is he? What's his name?
Carlos.
Who?
Carlos.
Hey, Carlos. What's your ghost of it? How are you, Carlos? Adam West.
Thank you.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.